Oh. Hello and welcome to the show. My name is Alex and this is TechFlow. Talking about tech, we've got a lot of networking gear today here. We're going to be upgrading my home network. Let's do this. So this right here is the Unify Gateway. I'm gonna go through what all of this is, and if you guys wanna do this yourselves, links in the description. This is probably the best prosumer networking gear you can buy on the market, in my own humble opinion. So that is our security gateway, the router. Then we have a cloud key, which ties everything together and lets me access the network remotely and monitor it. These are three UAP-AC-HD access points. These have in them multi-user MIMO, 2.4 and 5 gigahertz radios. These are absolutely mental access points. We've got three of them for Wi-Fi around the house. And then this is our 16 gigabit POE switch with two SFP ports. We've got a lot of gear to configure today. We need to start with the router, the security gateway. So I'm gonna try and walk you guys through as simple as this is. I know it's like prosumer gear, so it feels like kind of intimidating to set it all up, but it's really nice, it's really easy. We don't need the instruction manual. This is the security gateway. So this is the new router for the house. It has a nice LED ring round there, and then there is your power port just there. And then it comes with the wrong adapter for some reason, but there we go. There is our power adapter. We plug that in there and then we're sorted. This is our router. So a bit of background before I go into this. I actually run an ISP, an internet service provider, for like the people in my village. This is the router that has the main internet into the house, and then this actually distributes it off via this fiber cable to my current home router. We are going to switch that router off right now. Say bye bye, the final switch off to our last router, and we're going to be replacing this one with the new edge router, which is down there. So I'm going to get to configuring that with this cable. So this right here, this white cable, let's just pretend this is the cable, the Ethernet cable that's coming from your home broadband. This is the cable into your house, the Ethernet jack from your main router, your ISP's router. This is going to go into the USG, right? So this is the router of your new network, the USG. Right, most typical routers, you'll find that you'll have a switch on the back. You'll have maybe a few Ethernet ports that you can connect your devices to, and your router will also give off Wi-Fi. It's also got an access point built into it, but not this. All the devices are separate. So as you can see here, we have our WAN 1, which is the internet in, and then our LAN 1. There's only one local area network port, which means we can only plug in one device. Therefore, we need a switch. So we need a switch. This is where the Unify port 16 150 watt comes in. This is a mad ass switch. It has 150 watts of power, and why that is important here is because our access points, our three wireless access points we've got here, right? Obviously these need power for them to work, but you don't have to run an Ethernet cable to these and plug them into power at the same time. They actually are power over Ethernet. So you run one Ethernet cable to each of these devices, which also has the power. Now you can choose which ports on this switch are gonna give out power. So I can choose ports 2, 4, and 6 to give out power. Plug the Ethernet cables into those and then run these to the access points, and that switch out of this 150 watts of power that it has is going to power these access points through one cable. And as well as the cloud key, this needs power as well, right? If we unbox this, look, you can see it has a micro USB port on it, so you can power it by micro USB. But if you don't want to do that, you can power it via Ethernet, right? So there you go, it makes it all streamlined. We need to get this switch out the box. This is only if you're serious about networking. Like if you love networking, if you have like a passion for it, and if you always wanted to experiment, this is the sort of gear that you go for. If you're wanting like a proper full-on setup, this is what you go for. So it comes with wall mounts in the box, and this is our switch. It's absolutely gorgeous as far as switches are concerned. There's our power cable. There we go, obviously our wall mounts there. Before we start drilling things to the wall and setting things up, the first thing we need to do is get it all set up and working on the floor down here. We need to test it all, and that's when you start drilling, after you've tested. You don't drill and then test, you test and then drill. So I need to get this
hooked into our network and everything up and running first.
Right, so we're gonna give some power to our switch, and then we're gonna give our switch internet access via this cable from the USG that's just in there. So we're just gonna plug this into, so we're just gonna plug this into port one. I'm then gonna plug in our ubiquity cloud key, which is gonna tie everything together on this install. That's just gonna come up like that. And now we've got our three wireless access points. So we need to get these out the box. Let me show you what these look like. They're absolutely massive, but they are just the best wireless you're gonna get. These are incredible. So that is it. It's a dish you put on the roof, you draw that up to the roof like that, and then this goes into there and clicks in. This is gonna replace my older ones. As you can see, they're a fair bit bigger. So while I'm testing all of this out, obviously we're gonna test it up down here, so I'm just gonna plug everything in here. I'm gonna plug that one in there, that one into there, that one into there for my three access points, and then hopefully the switch to detect that these devices need POE, power over Ethernet, and supply them with that. As you can see, the cloud key is powered on through the POE from the switch. So we'll take these other two ubiquity access points out of the box, and while I'm doing that, I'll just explain again how power over Ethernet works and why it's really important. So say if I'm wanting to install this wireless access point in a place where there's no power source, what I can actually do is just run the single Ethernet cable to this access point to get the internet to it, and the power will also travel along that Ethernet cable coming off the switch. So if this is going in a remote location where there's no power, it's gonna work because the power runs over the Ethernet cable. It's brilliant because POE works with switches. So you could get one of these switches, a smaller one of these switches, and power it over Ethernet if you wanted to, and have it in a remote location doing all the switching for you. So that is why power over Ethernet is just so important and so powerful. So that is what POE is for. So this is me now on the laptop logged into the cloud key. So this is the little device that ties everything together. So obviously, as you can see, the cloud key has found 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 devices. I'm counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 devices, including the gateway in there. So we'll click next and configure all of them. And now it's asking us to create an SSID. For the moment, I'm gonna create a new network called Mars Media and give it a password. I'm gonna enable guest access and name the guest network, the name of my house, _guest. So there we go, I have internet. I can see my Mars Media network on my phone. I'm now connected to it. So what I'm gonna do is, for the sake of the testing, I'm just gonna unplug that access point and that access point, because these are all provisioned and ready to be installed. I'm gonna leave this one on just for testing purposes. And we'll just do a quick speed test to make sure that the Wi-Fi is you know, working, which it absolutely is. Now it's time to go make a mess and install these access points. Access point 3 installed. So I need to disassemble all of the SFP modules and all of the old router that we had installed here. And as you can see, I've got it all cable managed extremely, extremely well. There is our SFP port. And then that is an SFP module. And then these are the three cables that go to the three access points. So these will have the POE, power over Ethernet, for those access points. And then this is the old router, which should just come off the wall. Somehow, please help me. There we go.
put it where it needs to be and I'll hold it to the bottom.
Hopefully this works. It all worked when we tested it down there. It's now been drilled up. Hopefully it all works. Right, we've got internet. Let's see if we can do a quick speed test with everything all plugged in just to see what we get. Let's see what happens. 12 ping, and it should stop at 50 meg down and 12 up. Sorry, 50 meg down and 50 meg up. That's definitely working. That is definitely, definitely working. Right, connecting to the Mars Media wireless network. And as you can see, we're pulling the 50 meg on the Wi-Fi as well. And I can walk around the house and my phone will seamlessly go between all four access points. That's mad speed. Wow.
I only pay for 50.
Well, I only give myself 50. Right then guys, I've got sweat on my forehead. Recap over what we've done. We've taken out the old router, which was there. We've replaced it with the USG. The USG goes to the 16 port switch. The 16 port switch powers the cloud key, which ties all of this stuff together, which is like the console for it all. That's powered by power of the Ethernet. And then we've got the three black cables, which go out to our three access points. One here, one there, and one there. One of the most overpowered networks a home needs has now been installed. Here's all the boxes for it. This is everything that we have installed today in a massive mess. If you guys want a dedicated network tour when everything's looking, you know, it's not as messy as all of this and it's all a little bit, you know, a little bit more uniform, then drop a like on the video if you've enjoyed. But for now, my name's been Alex. This has been TechFlow. This has been installing Ubiquity full-on network in a house. I'll see you in the next episode. Adios.